All right, so here's the current progress with the mud truck. It's that Chevy that got literally buried by a flood, and I dug it out with a shovel, like, I don't know, 1 or 2 years ago. It's just been sitting over here at my old gas station, and it's just so heavy because it's full of dirt that I can't really move it. My little Bobcat tractor just has a hell of a time moving it, and there's no steering, and so this cab and inside the doors, I mean, this door, I'm not joking, because of the dirt, it probably weighs 200 pounds. It is heavy. And this seat was full of mud, and it's heavy. And you see this pile of dirt I got on the ground, that's just what I kicked right outside the door. But the inside of this cab is just filled with dirt. You can see in the door pockets and under the dash. And so, to be able to move this truck, I'm just going to completely take it apart. I'm going to shovel out the bed, unbolted. I just unbolted the front clip. There's still one bolt in the door jamb of that other door, but I can't get the door open yet, so I have to literally dig it out. But I'm going to just take this truck into 10 parts and put it behind the fence. And this truck's just so bad, it's only really good for parts. Hopefully its transfer case is still good and it's not full of dirt. But the motor is just literally filled with dirt. But I never dug a car out of the sand before, and I'll probably think twice before I do it again. But you can see there's like weeds growing up through. And I shoveled the bed out when I first dug it out because it was so heavy. But the leaf springs on this thing, well, you can't see it from here, but they're all inverted because there's so much weight in this truck. And there's really not a straight body panel on it. There's just, you know, pieces here and there that might still be good. Even the differential might be full of dirt because it has like a vent line. But the back window's good, and maybe the transfer case, and the frame got pretty bent up when we yanked this thing out of the dirt. So who knows? Like, was it worth it? Probably not. It was worth the experience. Well, I'm going to keep on going and get this thing taken apart. But I'm thinking at this fender, because it's so chewed up down here, I'm just going to use my cutting torch and blast a hole to get that last bolt out, because that door is just stuck, and the door is in better shape than the fender, so I have to sacrifice something. So, yep, that fender's done. So then after this is taken apart, I'll come in here with the Bobcat and put slings on everything and start lifting off the pieces. Yep. Okay, well, here's Hayden, Arizona. Nice and quiet. Not too many people live out here. All right, well, I'm going to get back at it. But here's the progress of the mud truck. Well, see you later. Bye.